Now notice what he says. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Now, there's something rather, well, I'd say ironical, and I would also like to add humorous. I've said again and again, God has a sense of humor. And this seems to me to be an instance of one. If you don't see that which is funny, well, then you just pass by it. It's all right. And all you'll see is just a bunch of dead bones. But will you notice Ezekiel there? God says to him, prophesying these bones. And you start out by saying, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. And I have a notion, Ezekiel says, Lord, you don't mean for me to start talking to these dry bones here. The man with the white coat and net will be looking for me if I start speaking to these old dry bones. And by the way, that's not a good introduction. You know, you wouldn't, no preacher would begin the Sunday morning saying to his congregation, O ye dry bones. And a friend of mine, who also has a good sense of humor, he said to me, he says, you know, I have a church. And he says, I'd like to begin like Ezekiel did. But he said, I dare not, because he says, the bones I speak to are just about as dry as Ezekiel's were. Actually, here he's looking out in a valley filled with these dry bones. And he's to speak to them. And gracious alive, what a picture that you got here. This man is saying that. But did you know that every preacher that's speaking today to a congregation, they're the saved and the unsaved. And those that are saved, they may have ears to hear but don't hear. And the ones that are not saved, they're dead in trespasses and sins. They haven't been redeemed yet. And he's just about as helpless as Ezekiel. Any preacher that knows the real state and condition of the lost recognizes his helplessness. And so this man, Ezekiel here, he's to say to the dry bones, I want you to hear what God has to say. Verse 5, thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I'll cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and I'll bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I'm the Lord. Now, God says, I want you to speak to them, and I'll be the one that will give them life. And that's our condition today. If God doesn't move, I've shared several letters with you where folk have said, you saved me. I remember one woman, that's the way she began her letter. You saved me. Well, friends, I save no one. I just speak to dry bones, that's all. And try to give the word of God. Now, the Spirit of God has to bring life. And that's the only way life could come. Now, that to me is the application here. Now, it's going to have a tremendous interpretation.